Hi, Koren.
Hiya.
What are we making today?
So, my friends, we are going to make a CBD olive tapenade. And generally, I would use these gorgeous Kalamata olives, but we don't have any that have been pitted. So we're not going to use these because it takes too long to get the stones out of them. But the Kalamata olives give a really rich, delicious flavour. And this tapenade is, it literally will take you a few minutes to make. And it's really versatile. You can put it on toast with whatever other topping you want to put on it. It's great added to pizza. We love it in pasta dishes, soups. So it's really quite versatile and it tastes delicious. So we need, to start with, we're going to use these olives, which is a bit of a mix, but it's mostly green. So you can either make green or black. It really doesn't matter, or you can make a mix, just whatever you've got to hand. As long as they're pitted, that's the key thing. So we want about 15 olives. You can double this recipe if you want to, but we're just going to make a small batch. We tend to just make it as we need it. So we've got about a few more. There's about 15 in there. And then we'll use half the amount of sun-dried tomatoes to olives. So if we've got 15, 16 olives, and we want about 8 sun-dried tomatoes. These ones are pre-soaked and sitting in oil. I generally tend to use ones that are dry and then soak them myself, mainly for the reason that they tend to not have preservatives added to them if you buy the dry ones. That's what I would look out for anyway. Often when they come in jars like this, they've got preservatives and sometimes other additives as well. And we like them to be as natural as possible. So a couple more in there. And then the only other things we need is a clove of garlic. We're going to add a little bit of olive oil. So I've got about a teaspoon, 2 teaspoons here. You can always tweak the recipe afterwards. So once you've whizzed it all up, have a little taste, see how it is, and then you can adjust it accordingly. And then a good handful of basil. So I really like the flavour of basil. Some people would like it just to be quite subtle. So I'm going to use a big lot. Load of that. So let's pop that in. And that is it. You might want to put a little bit of black pepper in there. Generally, you don't need to add any salt because the olives are already quite salty and the sun-dried tomatoes might have a little bit of salt in them as well. And then we're going to whiz it all up. It's going to be a little bit noisy. We're going to add the CBD at the end. Now, it doesn't really matter when you add the CBD. You could add it in now. In fact, let's add it in now. It doesn't really matter. I'm going to use this gold 5% CBD. This is my favourite choice for cooking because it's quite a clear oil and it doesn't have the bitter flavour that some of our CBD oils have. So it's much easier to disguise the flavour of it when you add it to food. And because this is probably going to be, I don't know, maybe like 10, 15 servings, we're going to be quite generous with the amount of CBD that we're adding. So I'm going to put a whole pipette in, which would be about 20 drops of CBD. And as I said, this is 5%. But everybody's different, everybody responds differently to CBD, so you can just adjust that accordingly. It's gonna be a little bit noisy. We're gonna whiz it up. A little bit of graft in here. Going with that to get it as smooth as you want to. Now you might have a little food processor. We have got a little mini whizzer here as well, but I find that it tends to blend better using the stick blender because there's not a huge quantity of it. If you put it in a food processor, sometimes it can just get stuck around the edges. This you can just keep scraping it in. So there you have it. Lovely, gorgeous CBD olive tapenade. And then you can put that in the fridge in a jar or a little Tupperware, and it should last you for a good couple of weeks.